Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Xenoblade Chronicles X. It's been a minute. I know. But that's because I've been a little under the weather, and recording a long-ass episode did not appeal to me. But you know what? I don't know why. Just recording so much was putting a strain on my throat, which was already hurting, so I was minimizing it down to 2 videos a day for a minute there. Anyway, sorry there hasn't been a video for a few days. That's the reason why I wasn't feeling good. If this is the only series you're watching, now you know. So, anyways, in the last episode, I believe I said I was going to do YELV'S next affinity mission. So, here we go. Chapter 11 done. Bolivia 50% done. Mimeozome left and right leg. I seem to remember picking those up. I mean, clearly I can. I could do the mission right now. Must have picked those up while I was wandering around. I'm guessing they were in Bolivia. I seem to remember picking some random red ones up when I was just walking around. I forgot to mention that, didn't I? Or maybe I did mention it. I don't remember. Or maybe I picked him up on screen. I don't even remember, man. Either way, let's do this. We're finally going to find YELV'S partner, the one he kept talking about so sweetly, like it was his best friend forever.
And his left arm. All we got to do now is hunt down his head and body. We're almost there.
Oh, just his head and body? Do we need... Sure. He's a mim. We can revive him.
Owen, did I ever mention his right arm? Because he kept it.
Shoulda known.
Day of the crash, I watched his skull get caught in that blast. Figured I'd never see him again, you know? But when I woke up after blacking out, his arm was on top of me. Like it was shielding me from harm. Talk about overprotective. That part...
Totes.
Believe a guy like that would be behind. Couldn't have. Please, you gotta help me find him. I need this.
Okay.
Not like going in blind either. If we triangulate from where the other parts turned up, we can narrow down the search.
I don't remember where I got the other parts. Okay. Yeah. Whatever you want to do, bro. Whatever you want to do.
I owe you one. Oh, come on.
Down.
He's waiting out there. We can't leave him all alone.
We can't leave him all alone. God damn it, we gotta go talk to Eleonora. Eleonora, where is he? Where is his body? Are we actually gonna find his friend? That's gonna be interesting if we actually find his friend. Anyway, I'm gonna be a little out of sorts playing this since I haven't played it for a few days. Probably been a good 5 or 6 days since I actually played this game. Been less time since I recorded one. I mean, since I posted one. But... yeah. Anyway, Eleonora, girl, what do you know about the dead guy? Or, let's call him disassembled guy.
What's wrong, Yel? You seem tense today. I mean, more than usual.
Stow the chit-chat, lady. I need you to drop whatever's going on and do me a solid. I'm gonna give you 4 sets of coordinates, yeah? You work out whatever pattern you can to try and lock down a 5th.
Oh? Is this about your friend's body that you two have been looking for?
Oh, for the love of clams, you told her about that?
I said nothing. I don't remember.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm just gonna assume you kept your lips zipped.
Yeah, totally. I knew it. I tell nothing.
Staying informed is my job, Yel. I know everything about everyone.
I know everything!
Now don't be mad. Already crunched the numbers. The Frontier nav probes you installed gave me all the data I needed.
Man, you really are a snoopy little snoop, ain't ya? Still, I guess it's okay just this one time. Thanks, Al.
Thanks for stalking me.
I'll send along the precise coordinates later.
Thanks.
Looks like your friend is waiting for you over in Oblivia.
Hell of a place for a nap.
Waiting?
Still, whatever. Let's get cracking.
Let's get it pappin'.
We'll slap that lazy so-and-so awake and drag his worthless butt back to New L.A. He's gonna feel this one, all right. Get ready to hurt, pal.
Is this gonna end sadly where his friend doesn't actually get to come back? I wonder. Or is this one actually gonna have a happily ever after where he actually finds his friend and we put him back together all Humpty Dumpty style? I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm actually very curious to find out. Anyways, to Oblivia we go! And, yeah, besides this mission, we're probably just going to do other side quest missions today, so, yeah. But I'm starting to feel like we should get to chapter 12 pretty soon. I just feel like it, you know? And I guess I still have a handful of affinity missions that I could probably do, and I might do one more episode before we do chapter 12, maybe. Still thinking about it, still contemplating it, still trying to make a decision on the whole matter. And I will soon. Is he actually in the cave? At Oblivia's... Head to the crash site at Oblivia's Eddie's Conquest. Oh, is that in here? It might be in here. There it is. I've been in here before. It's just like a little sort of cave. Alright. What do we got? Now I know why this place is called Eddie's Conquest.
Around here, based on the coordinates. Look, is that a person?
It's what a person? See,
I knew it. He's alive. Stuck it out here all on his own.
Uh-oh. Be careful, bro. Be careful.
Careful? Careful of what?
Don't get big-headed now. Don't be dumb. Don't be dumb. Yup, it's one of these bitches.
Oh crap! Look out!
Dear crap! Not even gonna mince words. Turn around, let's do this. Throw down, Georgia Brown, Mil Sadie, about to get wrecked right now. Booyah, bitch! This match is about to be over before it even started. Wow, only fucking that much damage, really? That's a disappointing amount of damage. Well, this guy must have good defense. Girl, guy, thing, whatever. Whatever you are. Feel my wrath. Bitch, just die already. And don't you dare think about killing my skills. For level 52, bitch, you got some good defense for real, though, girl. Whoa, dude, bitch almost killed my skill. Holy fuck. Okay, I don't want my skill to die. Get out, get out. Oh my god, no wonder. Dude, get out. Get out. Oh my god, my skill almost died. No wonder I'm getting wrecked. There's another enemy there. It's alright, we're good. Everything's cool. As long as my skell didn't die. Holy shit, that was close. Fucking down to 100. Don't get back in there, whatever you do. Not even a little bit. Just stay the fuck out of there. HB's a little low level. Well, no, fuck. HB, why'd you die? Bro, we might have to redo this battle. Wow, I can't believe this guy's so hard. For real? Is this happening right now? Oh my god, what the fuck, man? Is this happening right now? Did I seriously just die? Wow. I can't even believe this right now. Can't even believe this right now. What the fuck? I might need to go grab a different party member instead of Fog and HB. They're a little low level for this. Yeah, they're not going to win this. Alright, I'll be right back. Alright, so I finally figured out the problem I'm having with this bitch. She's making my characters attack each other, and that's where it's going wrong. So what I decided to do is take everybody out of their skills, except for me. So I do all the big damage while everybody else just attacks that bitch like goddamn, like a bunch of pack of wolves. And I'm hoping that if they do get turned against me, they just move the fuck out of the way or they die. I don't need them. I don't need them. All they did was hold me back. See how much better this is going now? See how much more swimmingly this is going now? That my actual attacks are actually hitting this bitch? This battle's over. Over before it started. Should have did this from the beginning. Anyway, victorious bitch, got him or her, whatever. And I killed the pig over there while I was at it. All right, not too bad, not too bad.
This is. It's the rest of him, but he's.
Uh oh, I knew it. It's not gonna be good. Comfort him.
Never coming back.
He's never coming back.
Together from the start. And now it's just me. Alone.
You're gonna make me cry, Yelv. You're gonna make me cry. You need to learn to stand on your own feet. Stand on your own feet, bitch.
That's what he's telling me, too. Even if this was his very last battle, he'd want me to go on living. The strongest soldiers can band together and stand alone, he used to say. It's almost like he was training me for this day my entire life.
Oh my god.
Guess it's time to man up and live up to the legacy.
How did I know the bitch was not gonna live? It was like that obvious. I guess it was that obvious.
The least I can do is lay his body to rest. Come on, Pard.
I'm dying to play chapter 12, especially if it's where we're finally going to get the life hold.
The debris we reclaimers find are treasure troves. I found mine, but the others back in New LA are probably waiting on theirs. We ain't done till every single memento of Earth is back in their hands.
All right.
Hell, it's what he'd be doing if he were still here to do it.
You damn right. Did you ever say his name, by the way?
You and me, side by side, till the last bit of wreckage is found.
Can we just assume his name is Eddie, since, you know, that's the name of this area that we're in, Eddie's fucking hole. Anyway, YELV, affinity mission done. Not too bad. Not too bad at all. Not too bad at all. Once I figured out that bitch was taking control of my shit, actually wasn't too bad. That was really upsetting me, because I was like, that bitch is kicking my ass. How is she doing so much damage? She was, like, killing my Skell in one hit and shit. Wait, what?
Yes, that's correct. Despite early concerns, the implanted memories have proven stable. Personality has also taken hold, thanks in part to a third party's help. If we use this master copy as the preset for the J-bodies in production... Yes, understood. Proceeding with phase two of the project.
What project are you talking about? Huh? What? Is going on. Huh? What the hell? What the hell? What is going on? Okay. That's very... Well, hold on. Maybe we'll get an answer. This is random as hell. What do you look so happy for? You sneaky bitch. What the hell's going on around here? Okay, there you go. Wow. What a weird ending to a quest. Alright. Intriguing indeed. Do I have the right level for this? Yes, I do. Hell yeah. Alright. Time to do some questing, my friends. Let's start with quests that I already have in my book. We have go to Caldros and find Lana. Go to Noctilum and find Disbeezy. Let's start with this one. I think I've had this one for longer. This one has been sitting in my damn inventory or whatever, my mission list forever. We need to go find Lana. Quick! To Lana Lane! Should I go get my other scales? Oh, you know what? No, hold on. I need to go switch my party. Alright, before we do anything, I'm gonna go switch my party. I'll be right back. I'll get scales and everything, too. Where you at? There he is. What the fuck are you doing over here, dude? I just wanted to fucking grab you in the party, but over here you are over here just standing and shit. Motherfucker. Alright, here's another heart-to-heart by HB, apparently, because that's the only way I can get him back in the party.
Let's see what you're capable of.
Ah, fucky G, impeccable timing. Would you be so kind as to drag me out of here? What? No. I see. If I may be so bold, sometimes I question your judgment as a blade. These ladies believe that I am humanity's only hope and will stop at nothing to curry my favor. In fact, they wanted to take me behind the bushes over there and suck my cock, but I won't allow that, unless... If I were to reject their sad, desperate advances, my reputation would be in tatters. They seek only the solace of a hero, after all, and his cock. As a likely candidate to lead Blade in the near future, I cannot allow unfavorable rumors about me to circulate amidst the rabble. Surely you understand this. Yeah, basically, you don't want bad rumors about how you lame in the sack, bro. You gotta prove yourself. Anyway, no. I had not considered that. You're saying they might actually have true feelings for me? That they might even be unaware that I am the elitist of all elites? Then that makes them all the more dangerous. I have no intention of allowing a female companion to distract me from my duties. And thus, like poor Phaedra chasing after Hippolytus, I think that's an old fucking Greek thing, maybe? I don't know. I fear their love can never be reciprocated. Plus, who knows how they might misinterpret the bond that you and I share. No, it will not do. I must return to the administrative district and begin drafting countermeasures immediately. Basically, what you need is something that makes you smell really bad and maybe get a little fatter. That'll work. Anyways, will you be in your damn spot now so we can put you in the goddamn party, you son of a bitch? You Achebe bitch. There he is. Alright. Now I'll meet you back at Caltros. Alright, Lana Lang, we are here to rescue you! Where are you? You're over here somewhere. There you are. You're over here on this... Okay. Are you good? I mean, you look like you got a companion over here. You over here just macking on a dude? Or what are you doing over here, girl? This is time to be brave, Walalo. New and happy life of Lana and Walalo is just at very beginning. Lana not let that end here. Hello, is friend here to speak with Lana? Confirmed. Boo Boo sent friend all this way to just to find Lana. Sometimes that nopon so... Never be minding. Now is not time to worry about Boo Boo. Friend must get rid of Monoceroses up there. Then Lana will answer all Snoopy questions. Oh, thanks. Make me kill all the things. Fine. You know what? I'll do it, but not for you. For the experience. I can use the experience. Holy fuck. What are you? Are you what I'm supposed to kill? Oh, you are. Well then. Scared me for a second. I was like walking into an enemy. Monoceros! Wanna lose, baby! Alright, look at that. Look at that damn damage, baby. Look at that damn damage, dude. These Monoceros don't even know what hit them. I already took them all out like a bass. And a Marnock for good measure. He shouldn't die. Damn it. I was hoping Fog would go up a level. I need to get these characters up to level 50 so everybody... I need to start getting everybody to level 50 just so everyone can goddamn use a goddamn level 50 scale if I want to goddamn do it. Also need to accumulate some more money so I can actually buy the fourth 50 scale when we have a full fucking squad. But anyway... What? Monoceros is already gone. Friend works quickly. Lana is impressed. Come to Durango Caravan, friend. Lana explained everything there. Alright. That's easy enough. I'm pretty sure that's the one right here in Caldros. Let's fly. In fact, we aren't too far away from it. Looking down at the map. Let's fly on over there right quick. Yada da, yada da, yada da, yada da, yada da, yada da, yada, 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 yada. Yada, yada, yada. Gotta fight that guy. Still gotta go fight that guy. I'm scared to fight that lava guy again, but I really want to beat him to get that last new record mission done, man. I really do. All right. Lana, where you at, girl? Oh, there you are. Wait, no. Wait, what? No. No. Spawn? No. Wait, where is she? The fuck? She's not spawning? Hello? During the day. Oh, my bad. It's nighttime. Is there a fucking clock nearby here or some shit? Clock. I need a fucking clock. Give me clocks. Birds go flying at the speed of sound to show how it all began. Cause we need a fucking clock to go right now and do what we need to do. Birds go flying at the speed of sound. I'm mixing up two Coldplay songs. Birds go flying at the fucking shit and I need to make it daytime now. Don't make it nighttime four times, fifth time. There we go. How can you tell the difference between day and night in the fucking Caldros anyways? It's always fucking lava, so you always can see everything. How can you tell the diff? Wait, where the f*** did my scale go? Bro, where's my scale? Bro. No, really, which one's my scale? Also, there's a guy here who teaches me things. This orange one, right? What the fuck? I thought I pressed the button. Like, isn't my scale the orange one? What the fudge? Alright. Back to the caravan. I already cut enough of this episode. That's the only reason I showed that whole debacle. Plus, I knew there had to be one nearby. Alright, Lana Lang. Spill the beans. What's going on, and what the hell do you need me to do for you? Or are we already done here? Let's find out.
Thanks
for helping Lana before, friend. And though brave friend saved precious life of Lana, Lana's still not going back to Boo Boo. Lana's staying here with Walalo. Lana love Walalo. Do not drag poor Lana away and tear Fluffy Heart into pieces.
I mean, you can't betray Boo Boo if you want.
Yay, friend is so understanding, so kind. Now Lana can start a better life here with Walalo.
What? Lana married to Boo Boo already? Walalo not want anything to do with this mess. Walalo is not wrecker of homes. Oh no, Lana not letting Walolo get away that easy. Real Nopon takes responsibility for actions. No way! Walolo heading back to New LA. Bye-bye, Lana. Ugh. Walolo a spineless excuse for Nopon. Now clever plan of Lana ruined. Unless... Oh, wait a single moment, Walolo. Lana forgets to mention one tiny little thing. Lana carrying little pawn of Walolo. Aw, she went there. She went there. She pulled a fucking Mari Povich on it. What? Walolo going to be dead upon? Yes, so grow spine and finish what Walolo start. Friend agrees with Lana, yes?
I don't think that's true.
Meme, friend is bad person to suspect Lana of trickery with no proof. Now come, Walolo. No time for arguing. Little pawn of Lana and Walolo about to be born.
All right. Walolo is nothing if about but fine, upstanding no pawn. Walolo will do right thing.
Yay! Now human friend will go and fetch materials needed to make good luck charm to ensure healthy little pawn. Lana need 6 malevolent Petroman silks and 6 golden puffs dropped by local monsters. Little pawn of Lana count on you, and Walolo. Little pawn of Walolo also count on you.
Do I have it? Damn it, I have 0 of both. Please tell me I have enough tickets to buy 6 of both of those things. God, I hope so. I hope so! I don't want to go fight puffs. They're probably not hard. These are probably not hard things to collect. But it would be nice to just use my tickets and do this shit quickly. I mean, that's why I let the tickets accumulate, man, for missions. Makes missions like this go by a hell of a lot faster. So if I'm not going to go fight everything and show you, the least I can do is show you what I'm about to do to get this shit. Alright. We need golden puffs. How much do those cost? Golden puffs. Puff! I have over 1,000 tickets. This is going to be very, hopefully, affordable. Golden puffs. Wait, what? Did I pass? No, I didn't even get to golden. What am I doing? Golden puff. Golden puff. Golden puff. There it is. 54. Okay, I can buy 6 of those easy. Easy. Okay, hopefully the malevolent Petroman silk doesn't cost that much. Is it actually called malevolent? Malevolent? Malevolent. Oh man, this is more expensive. And 6 in the bank, baby. Oh yeah, I used up like all my shit. Worth it to not have to go grind for shit. Loving it. I let those tickets accumulated relatively fast anyways. Like, I didn't use them for a while. So, I mean, that's cool. When I'm just playing the game and I'm not using them, it's pretty sweet because they just accumulate pretty good. And most of the missions I have left in the game are just beating hard monsters. So, I don't have a lot of side missions left to do from Mission Control. It's mostly collectibles that I haven't found yet or... monsters that are too hard for me to fight right now. Mostly. There's still some I can do, but I just haven't gotten around to them yet. Anyway, Lon, I got your shit. Here's your shit, you tricksy little bitch.
The little pun is coming! First little pun of Walolo almost ready to be born! Does it hurt, Lana? Walolo with you every step of way. Lana not going to make it without good luck charm. Has friend found materials yet?
She's probably just going to take a fat shit or Bart or something, you know? Anyway, here's your shit.
Meme, so perfect now, friend, and Walolo, wait. Lana be right back after miracle of childbirth.
Yeah, right back. Gone. Never seen that bitch again. Never gonna see that bitch again.
This part go here. Add eyes.
Oh, she's gonna make a fake one. And done. Never mind.
Walolo, the little pawn, beautiful little pawn of Lana and Walolo has been born.
What? She made a fake one.
This baby of Walolo? It's so tiny, it's so cute!
yeah. Really? Is this happening?
Wait, friend is right! Walolo sees sloppy stitching everywhere! Friend has big mouth!
Lana, what is meaning of this?
Oh, fine. If the jig is up, Lana tell you everything. Lana tired of clingy affection from Boo Boo. Whenever Lana want to go out, Boo Boo insisted too dangerous. Follow Lana around everywhere. Boo Boo even blow on every spoonful of soup when Lana try to eat, because apparently mouth burnt to tongue is fatal in world of Boo Boo, but Lana like hot soup. It was nightmare, so when Lana see Walolo, Lana decide to start new life here.
What? Walolo just pawned in game of Lana.
Failed pawn! Lana was so close to... fine, Lana will go back to New LA. Still, Lana enjoyed short time here with Walolo.
But our time is over, good sir. Walolo, you have been fooled. You have been played. Should've just took the paternity test, bro. Should've just took the paternity test.
Would've been a lot easier. And again, there was no baby to compare to because it wasn't real. It was all fucking hoax, man. It was all bullshit. It was all bullshit. Fucking Lana, man. Fucking Lana, man. All right. Let's get over here and talk to... What's his name again? Boo-Boo? Let's go talk to Boo-Boo right quick and be like, yo, Boo-Boo, you found your Boo-Boo. She sucks. Have fun. That's all you can say, man. Your wife sucks. Have fun. All right, Boo-Boo. You good? He must be good. He looks happy. Or maybe not. Are you good? Sorry, friend. Boo-Boo in middle of marital squabble. Lana not being reasonable. Boo-Boo was so worried, but Angel not sorry at all. Boo-Boo not want to talk to her right now. Ah, yes, here's reward for friend. Many thanks. I wouldn't want to talk to that BZ anyways. That BZ. Now that you know that she left on her own. F that BZ. She didn't just fucking wander off. She didn't get kidnapped. She fucking ditched your ass. She thought she was going to find something better. Like, not you. I'd say kick the BZ to the curb and cut your losses and find another BZ. You know what I'm saying? Anyways. Alright, let's go find Slavity Pagus over in Noctilum and beat the shit out of some freaking ganglions, if I'm remembering correctly. Because that was what she wanted to do. She's like, let's go fucking wreck ganglion all day. And you know what? I was down for that. It doesn't matter why or where or when. If they're reasonable levels, I will go destroy every goddamn ganglion in the history of the gang lions. Slavity Pogus, we got this. Aw, man, do I really have to get out of here to talk to her? She's probably like, you, go, kill all. I'll wait here. You, what are you doing? This will hold. This hole will do to start. Have you ever stormed one? Of course. Like bugs.
Then you need no explanation from me. I will say only this. Most ganglion fortresses are controlled by captain and vice captain. Kill both in one pass and chain of command falls. So I have proposition for you. I kill one of them, you kill other. Whoever has fastest time wins. Heh, fun, yes? Now we will know which of us is greater warrior.
Sure, why not?
Spoken like true prone. Now the challenge begin. I will strike hold first, you wait here. Captain Slavity works fast, do not blink or you will miss show.
Oh, you're going first, okay, I see how it is. You're gonna kill the easier one is what you're saying.
I broke Captain in two. He struggled longer than expected, 5 minutes, still not bad time. Can you defeat Vice Captain faster? We will see. Now go, tear him to shreds.
Alright, we got 5 minutes. Do we really have 5 minutes? Oh my god, we do. There's no real timer either, or at least not that it's showing me. Whatever, dude, let's go wreck this bitch. Come here, Captain. Oh, Captain, my Captain, you're about to get crapped on. Wait, where's he at? You on top of there? Wait, which one's the Captain? Are you inside? Bro. Where are you, bro? Is he above? I don't see bro. No, he's definitely got to be in there. Oh, there he is. Bro. You're done. You're done, bitch. You're done. Mil Sadie, Lieutenant, done. Oh, I already get that bitch in like one hit. And beat it. How's that for you, bitch? How's that for you? Is that fast? Is that fast enough for you? And time. Did it. Wrecked it. Boom.
Impressive.
Back already? And Vice Captain is dead?
Bored.
Heh, you beat my time. This round is yours. Now for rematch. This time I take second in command. You crush, Captain. That is only fair. I will go ahead. Begin scouting. You follow. Do not keep me waiting.
So she going to another spot? I think she's going to another spot. All right, she's going to Oblivia. Okay. Probably going to be slightly more difficult, but also not that bad because I'm super going to go destroy shit with my goddamn scales because that's how we roll. I think this place is actually a much harder place. The, whatever you want to call it. Wait, why am I getting out? Get out? You gotta get near the BZ before you get out.
Where you at, bees?
Yo, bees, where you at, girl? I'm here to kill more ganglion because they brought it upon themselves. Alright, BZ. You ready? Alright. Alright. You do this. You got this, girl. You got this.
Ah, here at last. I scouted fortress. It will be tougher than last one. All more fun. Added flavor to spice up little race.
Alright, let's do it.
Then why wait? Let Rampage begin. I was right to invite you along. I smelled bloodlust. Now to head inside. Crush Vice Captain. I will be faster this time.
Okay, go for it.
Ha! This time I have you beat. 3 minutes, top that. I'll be here. You go check Captain limb from limb.
Oh yeah, 3 minutes, huh? You think you're so fucking cool? You think you're so fucking cool with your 3 minutes? Watch it. We won't even take one. We're gonna take half a one. Where's this bitch at? I got this. Oh damn, she's all the way down here. Holy fuck, okay. I'm a little worried now. Alright, where's the bitch? Where's the bitch? Alright, in this tower? No. Lower tower, this tower. Alright. Where you at, bitch? Where's my bitch? I don't know which one's the captain. Oh, fuck, we're gonna have to fight this thing. Sorry, I pretty much wrecked the shit out of these things with my fucking skull. We should be good. Oh yeah, we're good. We're fucking good. Try not to use my area attack. My AoE attacks kick too much ass, and I don't want to draw in more enemies than I have to. Keep it simple. Oh, not the Faust. Whoa. Damn it. This is only going to ruin... Ah, fucking shit. If I can aggro the fucking boss, that'd be good. Alright, well, we got rid of... Oh, shit. What? Oh, I killed the boss. Did you see that? The boss is dead. I didn't even see the boss, but he's dead. So fuck it. I killed the boss. I'm out. Later. Haha. That was actually pretty freaking sweet. I didn't even see the boss. It must have been inside of the damn, inside of that tower that I was right next to. Anyway, that should be better than her time. I definitely do that faster in 3 minutes. If it's in real minutes. You, beat it. Done.
Impressive.
Your grin says job is done and faster than me. Being beaten is strange feeling. New feeling. That would sting if I weren't having fun. I can take on anything you can. Topple any fortress. Even Cavern Clan's Scabland Fortress. I had planned to end it here, but this is too much fun to stop now. One more stronghold, let's do it.
Alright, let's fucking do it.
You are best. I'll go ahead. You come after. Do not keep me waiting.
Wow, this is fucking... She's just one up in this shit. She's like, alright, you know what? Let's go to fucking Caldros. See if you can handle that shit, eh? 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 Alright. You wanna one up the ante? Let's fucking Wildcat Fortress this bitch. I got this. You think I'm scared of your little challenge? I'm scared of your little challenge. I will take the Wildcat Fortress like a goddamn campeón of the world. Of El Mundo, bitch. Alright. Slavity Pegasus. Let's see how fast. Is she gonna make me do it in like 1 minute, or is this one actually gonna take a minute? Let's see. Let's find out. Yo, yo, yo.
Earth alien. I was just scouting Holden, found treat. It is Magicia, woman who attacked us before. I am sure. Way of speaking, infuriating attitude, all just like voice I heard through gear. But did you not kill her?
Laugh and say we could just kill her again. That's funny.
This is true. Who cares about details? This time we destroy her utterly. Then she never comes back. This time will be my fastest time yet. Forgive me if I forget to leave any for you. Ha ha!
Alright, well, I'm gonna drink water while you do that. Oh shit. She failed.
So, you are Funky G then, a friend to this fool Slavity.
I don't remember if that was a prone.
I am youngest sister in the Magicia series. MG-068 Magicia, to be exact. I am speaking to you through that insufferable prone woman's comm device. Do you understand what this means? No? Then let me spell it out for your little human brain. Come to me now, or she dies. Do hurry, little insect. You killed my sister, after all. I would hate for you to be late to your own execution.
Oh, don't worry. I got something for your ass. You think I'm scared of your ass? I ain't scared of your ass. We're ready. Let's do it. Let's fucking storm the gates. Storm the gates. Okay, wait, hold on. The bitch is over here. We've already been in here, dude. We've been up in here. We rock this shit. Bring it. You're in a mech. That makes things even easier. Okay, you. You look like all the rest of them. You don't look any different than the other ones.
I thought you would flee, little insect.
Okay, I guess I could give her a girl voice. I thought she was going to be a prone.
But now it's time to atone for murdering my sister. I've placed a time bomb on your idiot friend, Slavity. Her death will come in 5 short minutes. Oh, but do not pity her, for she will not go alone. I will see to your execution as well.
Oh, good luck with that.
Now, share in your final experience together. Suffer and die in penance for your crime.
Yeah. How about no? I'm gonna go ahead and just chop your ass in two and call it a night, eh? Say goodnight to the Magisia. One chop it all it took. It took me 4 seconds. 4 goddamn seconds. Did you count that shit?
Bomb is removed. I am saved. Damn her. It must be holdover from cursed gear. As soon as I saw her, my body turned traitor. You had to save me again. I am filled with shame.
It's cool, man. It's cool.
I failed to defend myself, caused you hardship. I will cease rampages for a while as punishment. But once I am stronger, rampages will begin anew. I will return to New LA and start training regimen from hell. In meantime, take this as thanks. I hope to challenge you again someday. I will not lose next time. This is promise.
All right. Sounds good. Sounds good. Sounds good. All right. Another mission down, baby. Another mission down. That literally took me 4 seconds. That was hilarious. Okay, so now that that's done, what do we do now? Hold up. Let's get these bitches off my dick. Get the bitches off my dick. All right. So do I have any more missions left besides the lobster one? No, I don't. Well, in the list already. But I do have one that's already in my... Yeah, see, this one. There's one that I have to go talk... Like, there's a mission that's in the industrial district that I haven't started yet, and I've been kind of procrastinating starting it because I'm like, another new mission, But let's go start it now. If it seems short, we'll finish it now. Because in the next episode, I'm not sure what we're going to do. Because I don't have... I think I only have about one affinity mission ready to go. So I am not entirely sure I'm ready to... Or I'm willing to grind enough to get enough affinity missions going for the next episode, to be honest. Because that's all I have left. I don't have any more side quests that I know of, at least. Unless more have popped up since I finished the ones in this episode. I should go look around, and I will. But let's do this one first, and then I'll go look around either right after or in between episodes. Anyway, you're back. Okay, this is one of those BZs that transforms. Okay. You're back. I've been waiting. What? Surprised to have a criminal with a record of trickery come to see you all on her own? Larinara said he'd let me go free if I came and talked to you, so here I am. I have no idea what my next move is after turning on the ganglion, do you? You can join me. You taught me the joy of living, the workings of life. I'd like to continue to nurture that within me. But that would mean making an enemy of all my sisters who work for the ganglion. I don't know if I'm capable of that. Capable of hurting a fellow Definian, I mean. No. Allowing my sisters to go on compounding their crimes is thoughtless obedience is far... In thoughtless obedience is far worse. There is one task before me which takes precedence over all others. I must free my sisters from their loathsome mission. Will you help me? You are the only one in this city who knows who I truly am. I can turn to no one else. Fortune is coming topside. This could be our chance. Who the fuck is Fortune? Is Fortune a good person? Rescue Fortune, so I'm assuming that's somebody good. So let's go rescue the Fortune. I have deceived you time and again, and still you would help me. Thank you. I feel like I understand why Larinara sent me to speak to you. What the fuck is Fortune? The Sage Fortune has given our order since ancient times, though I have never seen her in person. She is being transported across Sylvalum right now, guarded by my sisters. If we can take her out, we may be able to free them from bondage. Please find that Definian squad and take Fortune from them. Alright, do you mind if I murder a few of them while I'm at it? Good, because it's gonna happen. Oh, it's gonna happen. I think we're good on time, because I had some pretty big cuts earlier on there, especially when I fought that bitch for the mission for YELV'. We should be good. We should have a good, like, 10 minutes at least to do this. So we should be fine. Let's assume this is gonna be doable, and let's rock the Casbah. Rock the Casbah. Rock. Are you ready? Let's go murder some Definians. Murder some Definians. Yo, wait, hold up. There's a treasure here. Hold up. Wait, oh, fuck. Nope. Never mind. Never mind. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I didn't know I was going to be fighting your ass. My bad. Murder time. Bitch. All right, well, we're fighting some extras because, oops. My bad, that's my scenario. Meant to get those treasures for my hoes. But you know what? That's how it goes. Especially when I murder like a fucking pro. Alright, now let's get my treasure. Sometimes no treasure must be left behind if you can help it. All right. All right. Okay, now, let's go deal with the douches, cakes, boozushes. They just right here? Indeed. Right here, indeed.
All right. All right.
Why are they just walking on through? Walk on through to the other side. Walk on through. Here come the lesser organisms. Who you calling lesser, bitch? You will kneel before the glory of our queen. Yeah, no. Fortune has issued a command in response to your barbaric display. You are to be put to death immediately. Yeah, good luck with that. No, seriously, good luck with that. No, seriously. Good luck with that. You're dead, bitches. You're dead! Dude, that bitch got killed in one choppity chop. And then one of these and it's over. It's fucking over. Dude, that fucking wing purple move is ridiculously good. Holy balls, is it good. Alright, Fortune. I thought you were gonna be like a human, but you're like, you look like the fucking ball from what the fuck's that game? The show. It's a show. It's about a ball that tells people who's gonna kill who and who's the target and who you gotta kill and who has the most points and who's winning. It's a show. It's an anime. They made movies out of it. What the fuck's it called? Now I'm mad that I can't remember the name of it. Shit. Oh my god, that's killing me that I can't remember the name. Anyway, you will not touch me with those filthy hands. I am Fortune Queen. Ah, fuck it. It's got the same voice as the girls. I am Fortune, Queen of the Dominions, and Keeper of the Galaxy's Wisdom since time immemorial. You will act as befits a lesser being in my presence. Respect my authority. It seems you are at least capable of some form of intelligent thought. Then I will not resist for now. Take me where you will. Truthfully, it matters not. In time, you will know death at the hands of my daughters. Yeah, I don't know about that. I'm kind of beast, and you wish. So, yeah, fuck you. Yeah, I mean, that's all I can really say. Just fuck you. Yeah, fuck you. That's like the most fucking straight to the point thing I can tell you right now is fuck you. So, yeah. So, fuck you. Anyway, let's go back to the BZ and give her the thing and see what happens. Maybe this quest will be over real fast. That'd be nice. That'd be nice. That'd be a real nice, real nice quest to be done. Be Dunzomatic. 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 Be Dunzomatic. I feel like this is one of those quests that's going to open up more, though. This feels like one of those. I feel her. You have brought fortune here. So that is what has ruled over us as queen and mother all these years. For all the crimes she forced upon us, I can't help but feel a nostalgic warmth. What are you gonna do now? Analyze the data first and foremost. My sisters are far too mercurial to pin down unless I have an absolute grasp of all the Dominions. I think it's time I had a long talk with mother here. And when I'm done, I will stop my sisters from doing any more evil, no matter what it takes. I remember what it's called. It's called Gantz, with a TZ, Gantz. I remember it now. All right, guys, that quest is done. Now, there may be some more quests around here. I don't remember if there was any other quests out in the world that I saw that I forgot to go start. Maybe? Hopefully in between episodes, I find something to do. Because otherwise, we're going to Chapter 12 next time, baby, because there ain't much else to do other than affinity missions that I'm not feeling like grinding the affinity for right now. So, actually, you know what we could do? At least check. I'm not going to check everywhere around the city, but at the very least, we can go to the Blade Barracks area. Check Mission Control, because that's usually a good place to indicate whether or not there's any other random side quests around. I mean, obviously, it's not the end-all, beat-all. You can find other random ones that are not marked there. But obviously, it's a good place to start. Oh, and the other quest that I completely forgot about, we have to go find Mia one more time in Caldros, right? Or at least one more time, as far as I know. And I haven't done that yet. So, huh. Oh shit, what? The final face-off. Well, there's another quest. Huh. That's only one quest. I hate to do side quests in a... Sorry, cough out of nowhere. I hate to do side quests in an episode where I'm gonna go to the main story. So I might just save it. Because I don't, unless I look around and find some more quests to do, that's the only one I have, and I'd rather not. Damn it. I'd rather not do just one quest. I'm kind of glad I'm wrapping up this episode, because now I'm on a coughing fit. Alright, I'm going to see you guys next time where I'll figure shit out. See you guys then. Peace.